over the hood of the car, hits the windshield, onto the ground. He's fine. Scrape, boom, done. I'm okay. We're supposed to believe these are humans. Okay, Kyle's human, Sarah's human. Even the car braking, like it was supposed to, you know, like, oh shit, person's in front of me, slam on the brakes. You're still going to hit that person. This is on a highway. You're going at least 45, if not faster, depending on where you're at and what the speed limit is. You slam the brakes on, you're too close, you're not even a car length away from the person. You're not stopping that fast. He's on the hood. I know you don't want to kill off the heroes like that. Fine. But he should have had, like, a broken rib or been unconscious until he woke up in the hospital. But they didn't do that. They both were fine. She was getting a staples, in fact, on some injury she had on her back shoulder, which I don't even really remember how the fuck she got that. I'm not going to rewatch the movie, which was returned to see. Once was enough, thank you. Once was too much, in fact. So, we had that. And a lot of the action scenes are just, why? Like, they flip a school bus, like they needed to throw in a Dark Knight moment. I thought it looked cool when they did it in that movie and decided to do it themselves for this one. It wasn't important, it wasn't necessary, it didn't really look all that cool. That's a bus flipping, whatever. The people inside were Kyle and Sarah. They were fine, not unconscious, not bloody. Again, a severe lack of any blood, really. And if you think this is long and meandering, you should have seen the movie. It just kept going. One preview I know they showed was Arnold in the helicopter, and he's jumping out. And he, like, just, you know, skydived, shoo, because he's going to go jumping down through, because he's a Terminator. And thinking like that, he's going to be cut the fuck up, but his endoskeleton is going to fuck up the helicopter he's zooming into, right? So he's like a Terminator bullet at this point. Watch that scene. And I'm expecting to see him all like, just like, zombie movie, like just Night of the Living Dead looking Terminator motherfucker, like just shit showing, right? Nope. Even his leather jacket wasn't really that ripped up. I don't know what the point of that was. If you're not going to show that he turned himself into a Terminator bullet or missile, zoom through a helicopter to take it out. He had to pass through the blade. They were over. Kind of like this. And in order to do what he did, he had to have kind of like come down through the blades. Boom. Okay, we know Terminators are some tough motherfuckers, but their skin isn't. It ages. It can get blown up, burned, ripped and torn, everything else. It's human skin. But he's not. He still looks like he's just a little bit, like, beginning of the movie kind of banged up. But that's about it. His clothes are fine. No blood. So then there's a big battle at the end. They blow up some buildings. This takes forever. Because there's a hologram Skynet that talks to him and taunts them and tries to convince them, oh, don't blow me up because you people are evil, blah, blah. Yes, people suck. Watch any news channel and you'll see the suckage that people have, I guess, innately within them. Again, I guess it depends on the person, but you see there's a lot of people that suck. So I can't fault that one. But I do fault the fact that they keep wanting to give a face to Skynet. That is why Skynet was such a real threat in the first two Terminator movies. They didn't give it a physical face. It was the internet, which is what we have right now. It's everywhere. That was the beauty of it. And progressively throughout the sequels, they have kept trying to give it a central, like if you blow up point C, you've taken out the heart of Skynet. You know, by this time, I don't think that's even really remotely possible. Because with the internet, it's, you blow up a cooling tower somewhere where they have a lot of the internet stuff housed. Maybe take out some of it. I don't think you would actually take out all of it unless you hit every fucking one of them. I don't know. I don't even know if that would be remotely possible. But for the sake of the movie, they want to keep doing that. But they keep adding a face. They keep making Skynet like this hologram thing that keeps talking. You shouldn't do that. Things that we don't see are so much scarier. Things that we can't rationalize with. That's why H.P. Lovecraft had the whole thing with Cthulhu and the elders, the ancient gods and that, the faceless things that you can't understand because you're not them. In this case, they make it less scary by giving it, one, they make it a kid hologram that keeps aging and jumps as it gets closer to becoming self-aware, which it's sort of already self-aware at this point. Within the movie. That's in the movie. They blow it up, and the buildings, there's five of them, I think, and they're set up in a fashion that it's a domino. It's nice. You blow up one, and takes them all down. Post-credits, they have the little goose that's like, oh, but there's a hologram left. It's Skynet. Yeah, there's going to be two more of these. Why? If we look back, I can almost guarantee, and I'm not going to do the math on that, but if we look back, you'll see that each movie, like, past the second one, which they could have stopped there, unless they were going to show us this whole huge war in the future that was not going to be Terminator Salvation, then that would have worked. But they didn't, so they could have stopped at two. One and two's done, fine. Destroyed Terminators, they don't exist anymore, whatever, fine, we're good, out. And that would have been strong. That would have been a strong two-movie thing, and yeah, something you can watch. Good. I think after the second one, each sequel has made progressively less. I haven't looked at it, the numbers, but just when you hear people talk about it, I didn't hear enough people love Terminator 3, or enough people love Terminator Salvation, or really anyone even mentioning seeing Terminator Genisys, to warrant them, why are you still doing that? You know, why? You can't say built-in audience because you're alienating those people that you're supposed to be trying to attract to see this. Casting was a problem. I had a problem with casting. I mentioned that a little bit with the John Connor actor. I'm sure he's, you know, I'm not knocking him. He's a good actor, fine. I'm not knocking you for that. I, however, am knocking the fact that they did not cast the John Connor that we needed to have to make all of this play out. I'm also knocking the actor they had for Kyle Reese. He resembles Channing Tatum. Which isn't, I mean, that's fine, but when you resemble someone else and people are like, oh no, it's not. Then they kind of see it as like a knockoff, like a blue light special clone. Like, oh, they couldn't afford that dude, so they got kind of a lookalike. And I'm pretty sure he was cast for his abs. I'm pretty sure because that was what you get to see. The whole beauty with Michael Biehn's portrayal of Kyle Reese was he was that normal guy who was caught up in an extraordinary situation. It just so happened he came from a time where he had to be a soldier, he had to be a warrior and survive, and he was able to do that. So that's what we had with Michael Biehn's performance. This one, though, no. He didn't, he's the classic modern day pretty boy athletic muscle dude, you know? I mean, he's cast for his physique, which is fine, you know, that's the whole different story. But he doesn't once convince you he's a badass soldier, not once. You know, there's no scars on his face that I could see, which is already a little weird. But, okay, fine, whatever. You would expect to see some scarring. I mean, they scarred John Connor up. They could have scarred Kyle. But okay, fine. So I wasn't feeling that. And Sarah Connor? No. No. Jesus Christ. I'm sure she's brilliant in Game of Thrones. I think she's the actress in that. The one that plays the Mother of Dragons, I think. I think that's it. I don't watch Game of Thrones. I know. I probably should. I don't, though. But I'm sure she's great in that, and I'm sure she's a good actress. But as Sarah Connor, she looked like she was, like, junior high. She just didn't do it, man. I mean, they wanted her to be the version of Sarah Connor we got in Terminator 2, where she's like this badass. You know, like, fuck me. Like, she's a Terminator herself, dude. And not once, we don't get that. We don't get that in Terminator Genisys. We don't see this version of Sarah Connor as a badass. She kind of, at points, comes off as a little whiny. Like the whole woe is me, like my life is mapped out for me, so I have no choices, but I want to have choice, so I'm going to say it. And that's where they fail. They say it. They don't show it. It's a movie. You can go ahead and show it. If we look back, and we shouldn't, because that's what ruined this, if we look back at the first two Terminators, we get to see that Sarah Connor starts out as a girl next door. She's not tough. She's a waitress. She gets kind of walked on, you know, and she's this unassuming person. And then we see in Terminator 2, she actually starts, because of all this, she more or less takes on like a Terminator mentality. And so she becomes pretty badass. And we see that from the beginning when she's plotting her escape from the asylum or the mental ward or whatever you want to call it. We see that. We see that she's prepared to do whatever it takes to survive and to make sure that John Connor survives. Even if doing that means she dies. She's prepared to do that, and that's totally badass. But not once does she say that. We're shown through actions, her interactions with other characters, and her reactions to what's going on. We get to see that. And in Terminator Genisys, this Sarah Connor did not pull that off. I know a lot of people were geeking out over, thought it was like chill, you know, goosebumps moment, and I didn't see it. Honestly, even when she does the whole come with me if you want to live line. In fact, that cheapened the whole thing. That was Kyle's line. Arnold, we love you, man. I mean, I get it. You know, you're the Terminator. You're Conan. But you're also not them anymore. That time's done, man. I mean, Terminators were infiltration units. And that means they could look like anyone. Or no one. They would be completely unique-looking individuals. Why? Because that's what humans are. I'm sorry, man, but even back in the day, Arnold, in his prime, he did not blend into a crowd. Not every movie needs to have an Arnold-looking Terminator in it. So I can't imagine Skynet has, like, 1,000 Arnolds just hanging off a hook somewhere. It's like, okay, send another one out. You're gonna catch on after a while. Oh, it's a bodybuilder. It's a Terminator. No offense, Arnold. If you happen to somehow, through a miracle of someone passing this on to someone, if you happen to see this, I got nothing against you, Arnold. I just wouldn't have used you. They're wanting to reboot the franchise. Why remind us what came before if you're trying to hope that you're rebooting it in such a way that we won't remember or cling to what we already saw? The script is a big problem. Just forget the time travel aspects of it right off. I can't imagine there was much script. There wasn't much story there. We don't have any moments where they really bond, Sarah and Kyle. Action scenes, they repeated too frequently. I like action in movies. But I don't like when you introduce the villain, and then you have like 4 fight scenes with that villain, and each time's like, okay, we beat him to this point, we get to run off, they're back. You know, save that beatdown for like the end of the movie. You know, that's how we gauge. It's like, oh, fuck. They got the bad guy on the ropes now, dude. This is it. This is the payoff moment. It would have felt better. As it was just progressively more and more and more. And the whole particle stream thing turning into a robot, I thought it was lazy when they did it in Transformers Age of Extinction, I think, or whatever that one. The one with Mark Wahlberg in it. That's lazy. You don't even bother now to have the liquid metal Terminators. You blow through those at the beginning of the movie, and now it's a particle-based thing that's lazy. It's not creative. I even saw a clip where James Cameron was talking about he felt this was going to be a renaissance type of thing, that it was going to rejuvenate the franchise, and that if you were a fan of the movies, you would love this one. No. If you're a fan of Terminator 1 and 2, I think you'd be hard-pressed to look at this as anything more than a type of movie. It'd be largely forgotten, too.